Currently, when I last checked, there were close to 60 private labs that had been approved across the country. Maharashtra has approved the largest number, about 14 labs. Suburban Diagnostics was in the first list of labs that got approved on 22nd of March. And the criteria is based on how many labs are NABL accredited. And so first you have to have a NABL accredited PCR facility. That becomes, I guess, the broad selection criteria. And then they go back and see the credentials and the experience, the network, and the ability to collect samples. So it's a, but I guess the basic filtering criteria is an NABL accredited PCR facility.
The WHO has given guidelines for suspect cases. What exactly is a suspect case?
So in that criteria, it's basically all symptomatic individuals who have undertaken international travel in the last 14 days, all symptomatic contacts of laboratory confirmed cases, all symptomatic healthcare workers, all hospitalized patients with severe acute respiratory illness, and asymptomatic direct and high-risk contacts of a confirmed case. This last category should be tested generally between 5 and 14 days after them coming in contact.
Sir, could you please elaborate on the PCR facility at Suburban? What does the testing process involve and how quickly can we get the results?
At Suburban Diagnostics, we have been invested in PCR for many years now. We have built a very state-of-the-art facility, which has got a unidirectional six-room concept, which is, according to biosafety level 2 compliance. And of course, we are mandated to use only those kits that have been approved by ICMR. So there were initially just two kits that ICMR approved, and now I guess over a period of time they've approved another two kits. The process involves, getting a sample in what we call as VTM or viral transport medium. Then there is extraction of the RNA, then there is amplification, and then there is the reading that is taken. And this process, the extraction and the amplification and reading, each take about 2.5 hours. So total time taken would be close to 6 hours for actual processing the sample within the lab. There's a lot of quality control that goes into it, internal as well as external. So currently, labs are giving a turnaround time of within 24 hours of the sample collection.
How are the antibody tests different from PCR tests?
The antibody tests are being, advocated in select conditions. They are not being used for screening. They are being used in those hotspot or high containment areas. That's where the antibody tests are being recommended by ICMR. And they have a different purpose. PCR picks up positive cases, within the first 2 days up to 12 days, whereas the antibody test will be used generally after the second week in the life cycle of the condition. That is to show if, the immune status of the person is been activated and they have antibodies against the coronavirus. So the objective, the confirmation is still by PCR. The antibody tests are being used more as for isolating those containment areas.
So, how many tests is Suburban conducting every day? And are you operating at full capacity?
So currently, on an average, we would be doing close to 200 tests a day. We have the capacity to ramp this up to at least three times what it is today. The capacity depends also on the type of kits that we use. So we have, an Altona kit, which is a German kit, which has the fastest turnaround time because it is a single tube assay. The Indian company, which is MyLab, has a three tube assay. So the throughput is one third. If we could use more of single tube assay kits like the Altona kit, then our capacity or our throughput will be significantly higher. But as I mentioned earlier, that because of the shortage of supply, we have to manage with whatever kits are available to us.
How are you ensuring the safety of people working at your labs and also your home sample collection executives, considering the need for social distancing at this time?
So we have two sets of teams. So the COVID team that is directly involved with COVID sample collection wears a complete PPE set, which includes a full gown with headgear, with goggles, with the N95 mask, with a shoe cover, as well as, you know, two layers of gloves. Whereas the other team that works in the centers at the back end is wearing goggles, is wearing a mask and gloves. And, you know, we are making sure that, you know, adequate protection. Of course, hand sanitizers is available across the network. We have also given our frontline team that is directly in contact with patients or suspect cases prophylactic hydroxychloroquine as recommended by ICMR. So we're making sure that we take adequate precautions for our team.
Do we have a steady supply of PPEs at present? What is the situation like for Suburban and for the other labs?
So initially we had, you know, one vendor who was giving us a complete PPE set. But today we have to procure different parts of the PPE from different vendors and then assemble it in-house and give a complete PPE kit. So yeah, it's not very easy, but because of the good relationships that our procurement team has with vendors, we are able to at least manage at least a week in advance, we get enough for the next week.
Dr. Arora, in your opinion, how is India handling the situation overall? Are we doing enough?
So I think I would, you know, give credit to the government in this case of, you know, first ensuring, you know, a Janta curfew and then a lockdown and then an extended lockdown. We are getting a lot of support from the local municipal authorities, you know, in terms of helping us with transportation, getting us curfew passes, helping, you know, our people reach work, also with supplies. We are seeing a lot of support from, you know, NGOs and, you know, other industrial or corporate houses. So everybody is, you know, trying to collaborate and, you know, support the healthcare workers in this situation today.
Dr. Arora, DocPlexus is India's largest online community of doctors with over 3.7 lakh users. We are a one-stop solution that empowers doctors with daily content in the form of scientific articles, quizzes, webinars, online CMEs, guidelines, case studies, and much more. Have you used DocPlexus before?
So I'm a member of DocPlexus, and I think almost everybody in my medical team is also a member of DocPlexus. But I would like to compliment DocPlexus for building a great platform, and I hope I'll be able to optimally put it to use in future.
Before we sign off, would you like to share a message for the doctors and people all over the world?
So I would just urge people, you know, that don't stigmatize this, don't ostracize the people who come positive, or don't ostracize the healthcare workers that are involved in, you know, working towards bringing this condition to an end.
That's such an important message. Thank you so much, Dr. Arora, for your time and for the insights.
Thank you, Sheetal. Thank you so much.